splendor of the King, clothed in majesty. Let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice, 'cause he wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at his voice, trembles at his voice. I pray.
We sang that song. How great is our God? Some of us, it's as if we're looking around, as if we're auditioning for the part. When you and I have all been called to be worshipers. Matter of fact, heaven had three distinct angels. One was named Lucifer, the head over worship. The other one was Michael, who was the fighter, and Gabriel, the messenger. But one day, the head over worship named Lucifer got pride, and God threw him out. Heaven still had a fight because it had Michael. It still had a message because it still had the messenger, Gabriel. But for a moment, it lost its worship. So God said, I must make a substitute, and I'm going to make man, and man's sole purpose of its existence is to worship me. You want to know why the devil hates you? It's because you are qualified to do what he's been disqualified to do. Are you hearing me? And so, the church of the world has made worship as if it's a denominational thing, as if it's something that churches do differently, like if you lift your hands, it's a Pentecostal thing, or it's a charismatic church. Baptists, they just sit there and watch. Catholics, they sit down. As if worship has to do with that. When you really think about the DNA of who you are, how God created you, how you're wired. When you watch soccer and they make a goal, that announcer says, goal, and he says it for like 10 minutes. Still trying to figure out why he says it so long. But when your team makes a goal, it doesn't matter where you are, you just go. When you're watching your favorite football team and they make a touchdown, you go. When your basketball team makes a winning shot, 16,000 people sit there. No, 16,000 people from a camera that's above, every arm goes. And yet, in the church, we have preached and we have said that if you lift your hands, it's a Pentecostal thing, it's a charismatic thing. No, lifting your hands is in the fabric of every human being. When they get an experience of victory, its expression is up like this. And so whether you are of the faith or you're not of the faith, when there is an experience of victory, there's an expression of your hands going up. I don't believe it's a Pentecostal thing. I don't believe it's a Baptist thing. I don't believe it's a Catholic thing. What I believe is when we lift up our hands towards heaven, it's a victory that comes with an expression of our hands going up, because God is a good God. How great is our God? How great is our God? He's an awesome God. He's an omnipotent God. He's a majestic God. He's the great I am. He's the Alpha and Omega. He's the beginning and the end. He's the bright and morning star. He is the awesome God that we serve. That's the God we serve. How great is our God? We come to church. We look around during worship, when it's what you've been created to do. Folks would walk out and say, well, that's just not my personality. It isn't. It's the DNA and the mere reason why you exist today. Oh, but Pastor Obed, I don't do that. Really? Are you serious? You worship. You're just worshiping something else. Have you ever thought, what does worship look like in heaven? I mean, do you think that worship is just this amazing thing in heaven? Our creative team got together and we thought, what if we give you a little taste of heaven of what we think kind of heaven hears during worship? You know, Psalms 148 says this, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the heights above. Praise him, all his angels. Praise him, all the heavenly hosts. Verse 3, praise him, sun and moon. Whoa, wait a minute. Sun and moon, praise him? Yes. Praise him, all you shining stars. Stars, praise him. Praise him, you highest heavens and you waters above the skies. Verse 7, praise the Lord from the earth. You great sea creatures and all the ocean depths. Wait a minute. Things in the ocean worship God? Yes. Lightning and hail, snow and clouds, stormy winds that do his bidding. You mountains and the hills, fruits and trees, all cedars, wild animals, all the cattle, small creatures and flying birds, all worship God. How great is our God. They all say, how great is our God. The birds in the morning when they sing, they're saying, how great is our God. When the trees begin to wave its branches, they're saying, how great is our God. And I thought, what if we showed you? So there's this star called the Vela Pulsar. 1,000 light years away, spins 11 times a second. This is how it sounds. It's the sound of a star named Vela Pulsar that gives the sound of its worship. I thought about another star called Tuck 47, which is 16,700 light years away. It spins 23 milliseconds per second, and this is how it sounds. It constantly gives a sound. It never ceases from the sound of worship that it gives. And then David described more than just the universe that worships God, but he even says the creatures of the sea begin to give a praise unto the Lord. And I thought about a whale. A whales actually sing to one another. They actually begin to make a sound that even from the depths of the sea, heaven is hearing a sound. That God didn't put a spirit in a whale and didn't put a spirit in stars, but he's put a spirit in you and I. And yet you and I can cease from a sound based on the conditions of how we feel, because we worship God based on what we feel more than what we know. And yet the stars and the whales never cease to give heaven the sound it was created to give. And I thought, they have a revelation of how great is our God. How awesome is our God. How great is our God. So I thought, what if we showed you again, but slowed it down a little bit? So if I took the Vela Pulsar, which 1,000 light years, and I begin to slow it down. And then I take the Tuck 47, and I begin to add the Tuck 47. How great is our God? And then I begin to take those solos and I add in the sound of a whale. When I begin to add in the sound of a whale, how great. How great is our God? And then all of a sudden I add the voices of earth. And I begin to add the voices of earth. And heaven begins to hear a symphony, and the whales and the stars and all the creatures of the earth begin to worship God, and they begin to sing, how great is our God, how great is this morning. And we come to church, and sometimes we don't feel like worshiping. And yet you were the one that was created in place to worship. And yet a whale never makes a decision and says, I'm not gonna give heaven a sound because I didn't have a good day. The stars never give a moment where there's not a sound. Wow. It gives to heaven. And yet, the church has become so lukewarm. We become so conditioned by denominations or what men have interpreted scripture to make you believe what their belief is, that you can sit during worship. How disrespectful it would be if the president of the United States walked in this room and you said, you were seated. I guarantee you, a military person will yank you by your neck and they will say, I don't care what your political beliefs are, you better get yourself up because that is the commander of chief. And yet, we will stand up when the president walks in. But I'm not talking about the president. I'm talking about the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, and will sit. My friend, you better get up and give God worship and give God praise. Oh my God. Jesus.